Not much to do down here. Inside this house, there's a door we can't get through just yet. So we won't go in there yet, and then here is where the drain is. And heed the warnings on the signs. You can save your game beforehand. Because this, from what I can tell, is the only part of the game where you actually can get a game over by performing something. So I'll show you what it does. And you just basically fall off the bottom of the world. And that's a game over. So let's load that back up again. And we're going to not jump in the drain because I don't want to die. If you look over here, you see another one of these goofy claw carts. You can get in. This one is a little more sophisticated. You have your choice of going right or left. The right path is a little more complicated, so we're going to go left first. Both sides have something that we need. Keep going. It's a nice leisurely tune. No, no, no. Keep going back there. If you get too far ahead of yourself, it gets confused. Doesn't make a lot of sense. Alright, so there's what appears to be a radio on the side of the lake wall. Take note of what's playing here, because we're going to need that in a minute. It's probably easier if you go to get the radio tune after you go off to the right, because you might be in danger of forgetting, but that's pretty easy to pick up on. We're going to ride this thing back around. And then we're going to go off to the right. You can see the paths are a little more complex. Around here and then go up this fork. I like riding around in a hollowed out foot. Stench is awful, however. Alright, these beakers. Take note of how much liquid and what color is in each one, because you'll need that for later. So I'm gonna dry out some beakers here. Let's see, blue, green, and red. The red one is halfway between each of the lines. The green one is at the second line. And the blue one is almost full. So we'll want to make note of that. I think around this corner here is actually a dead end. Although I don't remember. That's okay, the tune is nice. We need it. Yeah, it's a dead end. It's almost back to the bottom, but not quite. Damn you for toying with me. No worries. Around the bend. When you just see something obvious like that just sticking out, it just screams, "Write me down, you're gonna have to remember." This is like a funnier and much more enjoyable version of, like, Myst. So we can, I don't think anything is actually up here. One of these paths will actually lead you to something interesting. It's nothing important. Yeah, Well, this is actually kind of funny, too. You want to read this. The Cannon Monument. This cannon was put here by Hoborg, crossed out by some guy named Clog. Well, that guy's an asshole. Come on, get your ass down there. Let's go. Claiming we got some shit to figure out. Here's the next path here. And you'd think that you could just, like, cut a slit between these two tracks and let you ride on it, but no, it's not that creative. Up and around. We were up here earlier. Found a radio up there. Bring it back down. Chugga, 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 chugga. It's kind of like a roller coaster. You can cart this thing all the way up the cliff. Huffing it going uphill. Not enough gas. Better going down, it's faster. Now look at this. Dad! And a W and some shit strewn about. This looks like Willie's house. Rooftop loft. The location is excellent. The amenities are to die for. Yeah, look at that thing take off going down. Clay physics for the win. Alright, let's get our asses back down to the bottom. We have some more exploratorating to do. Come on, Claw Car, don't crap out on me now. Spinning around like that would make me dizzy. This kind of reminds me of that goofy weapon that you can get in Zelda Twilight Princess. That disc that you can ride around on where you have to ride around on the tracks. Reminds me of having to do that. Only that one, much more frustrating. If anybody's played that, by the way. I always thought it was kind of interesting how they made two different versions of that game for the Wii and the GameCube. But one was, they were just mirror images of each other. Kind of weird, anyway. Alright, now we got what we came for on the side of the lake wall. All good things. Let's go inside this yellow house thing. We have a disc. And what appears to be a radio. But without power, so remember that radio station, because we'll need to use that. We need to go back up. The power switch for the radio is kind of a pain in the ass to find. You'll be surprised when you find out where it is. Alright, well, we need the bridge back. So we have to go back in here. Click on these. Raise that shit back up. Got places to be, man. We need to teach Clayman how to run. This sauntering just isn't working for me. They did a really good job on the environments, though. I mean, this is really back when claymation was really a big deal, and everything was just painstakingly done. All the detail was really thought out. It's really impressive, actually. Claymation actually didn't get a lot of the appreciation that I think it deserved. Although there were some games and stuff that were developed that really just abuse the ability to make something out of clay and have it look cool, because they just sucked. Like, Clay Fighter was an example. It was an ingenious fighting game, and like, one of them was fun, but the other ones just sucked. So, anyway, it's this fifth ring here. If you jump up and grab it, you hear a cowbell sound. That is the power switch for the radio. Go figure.